I just bought Planet Coaster. These kind of games are my favorite, and I knew I was gonna love it, and I do love it. So I wanted to share it with you guys and show you how much fun it is and talk you into getting. So, think we're gonna do, that's supposed to be me. Thought we'd start from scratch. Actually, you know what? Oops. First, I'll just show you. Don't you love the names of these? I'll just show you one I was working on yesterday so you can see what kind of game it is. This is like Roller Coaster Tycoon on steroids, and it's great. I love tycoon games, they're like my favorite games in the whole world. So, when I first saw this, I knew that it would have to be mine. And I've been playing it for a few days straight. I plan to have a video up. I made a Skyrim special edition video pretty much as soon as I put up the last one. And I'm having a lot of trouble with it. It's still on my laptop in like a massive file size, and I haven't been able to compress it the same way I do all my other gaming videos. It's giving me a lot of chips, so. I thought I'd make this one instead to put up while I'm working on that. Sorry, I'm still just drinking my coffee this morning because I got up and then I decided to immediately start making this. Okay, it has somewhat long loading screens for me, at least. A big deal because the rest of the game runs fine. Oh, here we are at the entrance. So you'll have to forgive how extremely uncreative and bad I am, I feel like, at making buildings. So my park is called Sherwood Forest because I asked my husband what it should be called, and he said Richmond Park, and then I said no, and then he said Sherwood Forest. I was like, okay. I don't know why Sherwood Forest was okay, but Richmond Park's not. Don't ask me why. So yeah, all the buildings are I built from scratch. This is the park entrance, and currently it costs $35 for a standard ticket price, and then if you're in a group, it's 30 person, $30 per person. I'll give you a quick tour. The people in the park are great. Like, they're all. Oh my gosh. I just come across a person called Penny Lane. That's, I don't, I guess that's just unintentional, but yeah, anyway, I was about to say that the people are all really interesting and unique. And yeah, there's families, there's couples. There's couples, there's gay families, gay couples. It's really cool. And all races. Very neat. So, first thing when you come in, I've made a little information hut where you can buy. Oh, what happened there? Oh, I did not mean for that to happen. Just stick it on the ground. Anyway, sorry. This one of my favorite things about this game is it has a fast pass system. We call it priority passes, and I love that. Like in real life, like in Disney or something, you can get in an alternate queue that's really quick and you move to the front very quickly. So you pay lot of people don't like it, but okay, it's $15. And then I've got like four rides, I think, that have priority passes. So some people get them. You can tell that people have got them by the blue wristbands around their wrist. Oh, and this game is British, in case you couldn't tell. I got that very quickly when I read one of their thoughts that said that one of the rides is cheap as chips. Figured that out pretty quick. The ATM is not that okay, it's a little pricey. Alright, so yeah, I guess I can use the ATM. Blah blah blah. It has a very outdoorsy kind of feel, and I like it. Here are the bathrooms I made. Little resting area inside there with the water drop. Don't ask me why. And then this is our very first ride. It's called the Mill. Why am I? Yeah, it's called the Mill. So you come in here, and then this is where it diverts you to the Fast Pass section. Cause good God, oh dear, the line starts here. That's bad. I built these little buildings for you to wait inside, instead of just having them wait. On the open. I like people's hair. There's a really cool hairstyle that's like all rainbow and I love it. I'll have to see if I can find someone with that. Yeah, so the queue is massive. Oh my gosh. That's bad. It's really bad. I would not want to wait in this. And this is where it holds people off and then they let the priority people go. And you can give them low, equal, or high priority over the regular cast. There is so much like micromanagement in this. It's amazing. It's really cool. And then here's where you get on for the ride. So people are getting really, really pumped. Okay, apparently there's some litter we need to clean up. People wishing they had a priority pass. It looks magical. Oh, that's very nice. So, do you guys want to ride this? It's called the Mill, and you'll see why. So you can look at the people. You can... What is this view? Oh. Orbit. Chase. Look forward. I think we might do this one. Seat one. This is from people's point of view. Okay. So first we've got like a little water wheel there. That's one of the reasons why it's called the Mill, water mill. It's hard to see though when you stay on the side. Over there I've built my own windmill. This is more of like a family ride. A little family wooden coaster. It's not meant to be very scary. I love the tunnel system, like. That's it. What is that? I just noticed something is very wrong with the roof. Anyway, after people go on the ride, they leave this way and they exit through the beautiful scenery. So beautiful. What is happening up here? See, I can go in, I can edit the building, I can delete the piece. It's got a nice snapping system, it's very easy to use. Oh, I'm very happy with it. Anyway, that's the first ride, the Mill. Then I have like a little baby ride here. It's a carousel for people who are into the baby rides. It also has a fast pass system, so you normally would wind this way and then all the way down and all the way down and around, or you could just skip past all of that. And it's got some nice little scenery pieces. Oh, I need to put some right here. A big thing is like queue scenery. People will rate you on how interesting the wait is, and I will get bored. Okay. Over here is where you go eat. So this is, we have a hot dog squad in Monsieur Fleet and a cheap beef, and they're standing in the building. Gotta fix that. Over here's the drinks. We've got Cosmic Cow milkshakes, Street Fox coffee, which reminds me to drink my coffee, and Gulpy energy. There's a couple more choices. The food and drink. There's like a Gulpy slushy, and then there's like a Mexican restaurant. I'm hoping they'll add some more, because I think we could use more. And then there's, God, there's so much, like, you can customize so much. You can change all the prices. It's a little pricey, I agree, but I'm trying to squeeze every penny I can out of this place. Oh yeah, you can even, like, go in and give them ice cream, marshmallows. Let's do marshmallows and the strawberry one. Let's do ice cream and the vanilla. And fudge bits in the chocolate shake. I don't like the ice, we're not gonna put ice in there. Anyway, and then over here we've got just plain shopping. Ooh. Okay, there's anything that's a bit expensive. I don't want to turn down sales. The balloons place is probably fine, but the hat place they sell is a little too much. Let's bump everything down to 13. Okay, that's my little shopping center area. And now if you head this way, you will see my second ride called Pirate's Plunge. So we've got yet another, but this one has a really long queue always. Here, standby. Kind of horrible to look at. And here is Fast Pass. See, they're worth it. They're worth the price. And right on time, here's one of the log flumes. Which car is this? If I can change. Which one I look at? Here we go. I've got it spaced out pretty much that as soon as one leaves, another one comes in and then you board. And then it spaces out the time nicely. See, now the people are gonna get on. And we've let that one go ahead of us. Okay, so as you can tell, this one has a pirate theme. You make it wet. So there's like a whole theme to it. This little sailor pirate guy has been shipwrecked or marooned or something, I don't know. And he's lost his buried treasure. Or he's looking for buried treasure. There's a pirate up here. He's put together like a little camp. And there's like a little pirate camp over here. This is like a combination of Splash Mountain and Pirates of the Caribbean, I guess. And I really hate how you can't see that because I put a lot of freaking work into this ride. A stupid amount of work. Like, there's a whole area with the British over here. Like, there's a bunch of redcoats, and you can barely see them. It's so irritating. Oh, and it's getting dark. Perfect. There's a really cool galleon over there with pirates fighting. This always makes me want to play Black Flag. And now we're in pirate territory. I feel like Leia's gonna bark. She's just staring out the window like she always does. Oh, you can see one of my other rides, Atmosphere. It's not very piratey, I'll have to cover it up with some trees. You got a little pirate battle going on here where the British have invaded Pirate Town. You can see the galleon over there. There's more piratey town stuff, but you totally can't see any of it because you're really short, apparently. Oh my. Look at the moon. And this is gives you a better cute view of the galleon. And then right when you least expect it. Okay, right when you most expect it. The big plunge. Whee! Splash. Oh no, we're going in the skull cavern, which looks like something from Suicide Squad. And there's our hero with his buried treasure. And that's the end of the ride. So, I think this one's like medium intensity. Actually, it's pretty low intensity. The mill's probably medium intensity. Hi, Leia. Can you not whine? You can come sit with me, but you can't whine. See? So I've spaced it out just right. Anyway, when you get off, you just get off, right? Here. Yeah, people queue for. Look at the average. The queue time is 114 minutes. That is painful. That's longer than most rides at Disney World. However, the priority pass wait time is 8 minutes, so that's like way better. And there's the Lunar right here. You people are disgusting. What is wrong with you? Throw out your trash in the appropriate bins, please. Nasty people. When you come out, you're right by the little pirate camp. Anyway, let's move on to Atmosphere, which is my third custom built ride. You have to go down this path, way down here, and oh god, more trash. Disgusting people. Put your trash in the bin. We have twins. Shanda Hanks. Leia, why do you have two of my headbands in your mouth? You look really pleased with yourself right now. You look really happy. You hear that? That's her tail. Okay, so I want to just point this out. These women look exactly alike. Okay, now that I'm looking at them closely, they actually don't look exactly alike. I'm pretty sure they have different skin tone, but they have the exact same hair and glasses. No wonder they're best friends. That's cute. Oh, they're teenagers. I didn't realize that. Okay. So, to encourage people to come down here, I added a couple more food and drink stations. Gonna add some stuff here, but I can't think of what. Go up the stairs, and you have our most thrill. Are you serious? There's trash cans right there. Like, literally right there. What's wrong with people? You have our most thrilling ride, Atmosphere. It's the best. I'm super proud of it, but it's really intense. That woman looked like she was about to fall off. Anyway, this is the normal queue. You go woom, 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 woom. Oops. Oh my. But the priority goes around here and rejoins. It's actually not that much quick. It's not that quick, but it's substantial. Yeah, there's just this big massive building. And let's ride it. Okay, the terrifying thing about this ride is that it's backwards the entire time. I love it. I've got a Kraken in there. You barely see him. It's like a giant animatronic Kraken thing. It's amazing. Lay's just sleeping with my headbands right now. She's too cute. It does slow down a bit when you get to the top. It's kind of funny. Ready? Here we go. Ooh. I love this ride. Think it's a good value. Oh, yeah, that's right, it's free. I just have people pay to get into the parks and not to, let's watch it go. Yeah, I have people pay to get in the parks, not pay by ride, but you can do it the other way. You can have them pay by ride. You can have them pay to use the bathrooms. So I just thought we would have fun and make our own kind of park. And if by the end of this video you don't want to get this game, then I've not done a good enough job. Because you should get this game. Like at first I really wanted it and I thought it was a bit expensive, but I don't know, I think it's worth it. There's so much detail put into this. I'm like a big theme park fan, you know, as like quite a proof of that. As a lover of Disney World and everything. Speaking of Disney, I went to Disney and I vlogged about it, so if you want to watch that, I'll put a link in the description like always. So anyway, that is Sherwood Forest so far. Let's save it and go open a new one. A lot of these are careers, that's why I have so many in such a short period of time, is I've been playing basically campaigns. So I thought we might do a challenge map. Let's do Let's do a tropical theme. No. Let's do easy. We can sit here and think about. Oh, okay, that was really quick. So they give you challenges, of course. Achieve a park balance bonus. I don't know what a balance bonus is. Oh yeah, the management screen is. Here's the overview. You've got your finances. You can take out loans. You can research more rides and more stuff. You can do marketing campaigns to attract like a certain kind of people, teenagers, families, adults. You can hire staff, janitors, mechanics, all these entertainers. And you can keep an eye on your staff here. Pay them more, pay them less. Check out your demographics, see how much they spend, see what they like. Where they spend their time, and the Mondeer attractions. It's like, it's a micromanager's dream. So here's the park entrance. thinking. I don't know what I'm thinking, actually. Well, I'm thinking we close the park, first of all. Let's do... Oh, there we go. We'll have like a main street. The main street can branch off. And it looks like a fork. Perfect. Now, the path system can be a bit tricky at times. I was thinking, I don't want to make my own building, so I'm gonna steal some. They have, like a bunch of theme buildings. Look how great this is. Got a nice pirate theme. Check out this one. Look at how great this is. It's amazing. We've got a western theme. Look at that. I love it. Got a sci-fi theme. Okay, it's pretty boring. Actually, it's not too bad. You could make this whole part like inside a ship. You've got like a little village. Oh, I did not mean to do that. Village theme. I like this one. So I think. We'll go with this one, Chief Beef. And you know what? We can actually have people come in just to buy burgers. Might as well open it. And then we'll have a drink stand. And you can edit all these buildings, add whatever you want. So actually, I keep hitting my freaking mouse on that thing. Like for them to go together, kinda. They line up pretty well. Anyway, but we don't want another Chief Beef. So let's head to this building and destroy it and get rid of this giant burger sign because it's misleading. And instead, we'll put in let's do a gulpy slush. Yeah. Perfect. And then since we're doing that, we'll go into building custom and add a sign. Shop signs. Which one is like the slushy sign? do this. Oh, a new challenge is available. We'll achieve a monthly profit. That's not too bad. We can do that easily. Let's match that sign. I like this one. And actually, we can have like a... Perfect. Is anyone coming in? Yay! First customer! Aren't there any benches? This is proving to be an expensive little strip, and it's actually really long. I didn't think it would be that long. Anyway, let's see if there's any more interesting blueprints. That was expensive, which is why it's nice to. But there's just 3 hat stores? That seems kind of ridiculous. I feel like we don't need 3 hat stores. Actually, we'll put 1 back because. Why didn't you want one? You don't want a hat. Don't you want a hat? Got a cute family here. And he's wearing like a little football jersey. Buy a hat, guys. Don't walk into the mall. The side can be the Caribbean side, the side can be the pirate side. Anyway, let's build a ride. To get a loan as well, because I'm running out of money. Okay, Leia. Alright, and let's do a coaster. Let's do a crazy one. I like the inverted ones. Can change the way the station is oriented, so you can have people enter and exit from different sides, which is probably better. Alright, now we're gonna have a chain take them up. It's gonna be expensive. We'll have to keep it pretty short. Use this tool to make pieces shorter or longer. And let's do a normal track piece now. great at designing coasters. I'm getting the hang of it though. It's fun. And then we can say start test, and it can be running it constantly to see, you know, if your physics are lining up and yeah, if what you're doing makes sense. Like, I wonder if we have enough energy to do that. That's pretty cool. See if we made that. Oh, we can't make it any smaller. Let's try it. Yeah. No! So what we can do now is take this piece and we can just drop it more. Of course, I didn't expect it to make it all the way up because we didn't get the initial momentum. Let's try again. And we can also bring this piece up a bit more. Of course, it brings the whole thing up. Actually, you know what? We could actually do that. This piece wouldn't need. Just trying to do this piece. Oh, okay. Well, it doesn't like it. Anyway, come on, start the test. And then once it finishes, it gives you your excitement, your fear, and your nausea levels. I think it's gonna make it. That's a pretty slow. That's the best part. That was pretty slow, but I wonder if I could actually bring it down just a bit. There we go. And then one of my favorite things to do, as I'm sure you saw, is to make dolls. It's really fun. Let's see about that actually. I was hoping to. Oh wow, that's amazing. But that wouldn't go another way. Can we go down? I wonder if I can do it myself, actually. Actually, let's go back and twist this piece. No, I can't do it. I really want to go straight down though, so I guess we'll leave it alone. Just straight down into the earth. This is terrifying. Is falling asleep, the one that's like controlling the keys. Not good. Kind of hard to see what's happening here. This is a very scary ride. I think I have an idea for what I want. I think actually I'll just do it myself. Oops, I did not want that. Does that? I can't even see. It's the worst thing. Come on. There we go. I really need to add some lights down there. Okay, so gonna call it the sea serpent since it like snakes up and down. This ride is probably terrifying. I do not think I would want to ride this. Sometimes if your ride is too scary, people won't go on it. I found that out yesterday when I made a really scary ride And I had to like practically charge free entry just so people would freaking go on it. And it was really irritating. I really liked it. I was super proud of it. Other people didn't feel the same way, apparently. Oh well. I loved it. At this point, I'm not sure what I'm doing. Now I'm not doing. Kinda need to watch it go from here. So I was wondering if we could do like a little, well, half loop kind of thing. Oh dear God, not that. Bye. I think we can handle that. At this point, it's time to bring it home and try it. We can add brakes to slow it down. Okay, I think it's time to try it out. Wow, there's only one like little... I could have sworn there was more than one car. Did I make that up? Did we lose some along the way? Oh, I'm confused. What is it? Yeah, there's supposed to be 9 cars. There they are. Oh dear, that worries me. Anyway, let's try it out. So yeah, I'm gonna call this the sea serpent, I think, the way it snakes in and out of the ground. I guess we could call it the kraken, but that's not very, I don't know, original. Here we go. Oh, come on, this ride is great. I like it. I would totally go on this ride. It was good. I like it. Oh, we didn't lose any cars along the way. I didn't even realize Leia is sitting right behind me. How did I not realize that? She's so sneaky. Okay, place the entrance, place the exit, and I'm not gonna be precise about building like a little thing to house it in. Not really. Let's make it cute. Let's do the Brick King or the Cobble King. We'll do the Brick King. I predict long lines for this. I like to just sneak them around. I think it's the simplest way. That's long enough, really. And then we need an... What were we using over here? Oh yeah, this one. So as you can see, it's got a, wow, I did not even realize that I have so little money. I wasn't even paying attention to my funds, and now I have negative cash. Well, isn't that great? Alright, I need people to go on my ride so I can actually have more money. This is disastrous. Open the ride. Oh, it's way too little. Come on, people. Oh god, we're down $71. Let's get out of here. Really? Come on, guys. Oh, there's no bathrooms. That's probably something I should have thought of. Of course, now I don't think we even have money for bathrooms. Which one would we do? How much does that cost? Like $1,000. Oh my god. People, please go on my ride. Is anyone gonna go on the ride? Please. 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 Time to up the prices a little bit. Actually, we can do $12.50. Why did she just walk away? So, you see, making a park is hard. Wait, first of all, why did she walk away? Is it too expensive or something? Wait. I didn't even check the intensity ratings. What is it? Oh. Oh. So, that's not good. That's kind of worrisome. Great, so now that we've built this ride, no one's gonna want to go on it. Which means we need more teenagers, because teenagers always have high fear and nausea preferences. Usually, I say that. So they'll probably go on it. Ugh, how dare you. Seriously. I think we need to start charging. Just like a tiny bit of money, at least we can make some cash. Are you serious? Everyone is walking away? Oh, that's awful. No one will go on a ride. This is very failed. Come on, you really gonna turn that down? Oh my goodness, that is cheap. How is 50 cents not cheap? Come on. Oh my goodness. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Come on, guys. Come on. Come on. What if it's free for family members? The family trip ticket is free! What's the matter with you people? God, can't even charge for something so simple. This is turning out to be kind of disastrous. Oh my god, I got that loan and immediately, like, oh, this is probably the worst one I've ever had. Now I feel like I need to take out another loan. And there's nothing I could even sell here. Okay, maybe I can sell these trees. Sorry. I feel like a monster. I'm selling nature. Wait, why can't I sell? I can only sell these? Why? That only cost me $30. Why can't I sell these trees? Why? They're locked. Well, that's irritating. What if I turn the price down a bit for it? And I can't even do marketing, I don't think, because I don't have nearly enough money for it. Come on, guys. Seriously, just call my ride. What's the matter with you? So the one thing that we spent all of our cash to make is too intense for anyone to go on. Well, I'm very sad because I really liked it and I thought it was great. But apparently, not everyone thinks so. We can at least have like another little ride over here. There's no pirate theme with that though. I want a pirate theme. What is that? I don't even know what it does. That looks pretty good. But this thing's the cheapest. Are there any other cheap things? That one's pretty. It's pretty good. But I have to change the colors because. I don't like the green. Just make it a plain brown. Because it's pirate-y. Well, at least I'll make some money. So anyway, now you've seen the game, and you know what not to do. Don't build, don't put all your money into making a really scary ride that no one wants to go on. Because they won't go on it. Even though I would totally go on that. It's not that bad. The one I made yesterday in another park is like 5 times scarier. Sure, I have it facing the wrong way. Great. But if I move it, it will shut the whole thing down, and now everyone waiting in line will leave and have to get in line again. So that's kind of sucks. Is anyone gonna go on this ride? Come on, Laura. Wait. There's a glitch in the matrix. What's happening there? Anyway, hope you enjoyed this kind of terrible Planet Coaster video. I'm going to be deleting this park, as there's absolutely no reason to keep it. Because it's terrible, even though the sea serpent is amazing. And people need to just suck it up and go on anyway. Let me know if you get it, and if you make some parks. I look terrible compared to most people's. Talk to you later.